Hello everybody. So today we are going to talk about epic. This is a form of poetry. And in this session, we'll be talking about the introduction to epic, the structure and theme in an epic, and great epics ever written. And we'll be also talking about the mock epic, which is a type of epic that originated later on. So to begin with, let's see about the introduction. So epic is a very long narrative poem, and it relates great event in a grand style to lead to a very noble conclusion. So epics are written, it can be compared to novel because it can be written for pages together or books together. If you look at any epic that existed till date, whether it's Ramayana or Mahabharata or Beowulf or Aeneid, anything, it can go up to books. Like book 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So these are very long narrative poems written, and the theme being chosen to write an epic is also very elevated and lofty. So there is immense amount of story that develops in terms of time. It's not that it simply deals with one plot. There are many subplots revolving around it, and that becomes very long enough to write an epic. So great events happen in an epic, and to convey these great events, it's written in grand style, and this obviously leads to a very noble conclusion. So everything in the epic is lofty and nobility. So epic is considered as highest genre of poetry. So this is one of the highest genre of poetry ever written. So if you take up a poetry, the lofty poetry is always considered as epic. So let's move towards the structure and theme of an epic. So if you look at the theme of epic, all the epic will be celebrating the life or the heroic deeds or the achievements of great heroes. So epics will be usually revolving around great heroes. So if we take up the Beowulf, the earliest known epic in English, we find that it's the journey of Beowulf, the hero, towards killing great monsters, those were affecting the humans to live on earth. So it's the journey of Beowulf and his great deed. This is his heroic deed of killing the monster which nobody could kill. If you look at Aeneid, it's the life story of Aeneid, the great hero, Aeneid, who goes through many ups and downs and he finally wins. If you look at the Indian epics like Ramayana or Mahabharata, again it's very much heroic and it's the life story and it talks about the achievements about the great heroes. Now if you look at the structure of an epic, it is a very long narrative poem of dignified theme. It's not about the common people or common lifestyle. The stories or the plots that we find in an epic, we cannot find it anywhere else. It's not a common kind of theme that's being found there. The theme is very much dignified. It's rare themes are taken up to write an epic. Now, there is an organic unity. Even though there are many subplots running along with the main plot, there is an unity of everything that is being put together to give up this noble poetry. And the progress is also very much orderly. It's not that it jumps up here and ends there. No, it is very much orderly. The progress of telling the story is very much progressive and orderly in nature. So this is a very long narrative poem of action and grand style. You can find all sort of dignified things in an epic. Now, some of the great epics written ever on earth are the Mahabharata, the Ramayana, Virgil's Aeneid, Milton's Paradise Lost, and Beowulf, one of the earliest epic in English. As far as now, we do not know who has written it down. But yeah, there exists a book named Beowulf, which is one of the earliest. Actually, it belongs to the Anglo-Saxon or the originating period of English language. So let's talk about the mock epic. Now, this is a paradoxy of a real epic. So this is a paradox of a real epic. This is not equivalent to the real epic. Now, if you take up a real epic, we find that everything inside a real epic is very much dignified. It is very much lofty. It is of noble thoughts and all. While in the case of a mock epic, it's just like mocking. The content in the mock epic is satirical. It is completely opposite or reverse to the original epic. So it is a light and non-serious mood. The mock epic temperament itself is very much light and non-serious. It is written on a trivial or funny supernatural machinery of a real epic. Even though the content seems to be like noble and the theme line seems to be like the real epic, when written down, the content is put in such a manner that it is simply mockery or satirical view. So this is used to provoke satirical humor among the readers. So one such example of the mock epic is Rape of the Lock, written by Alexander Pope. So this is all about epic. We have seen about the real epic and the mock epic that emerged later on. While the real epic is of lofty nature, of noble thoughts, of dignified characters, while the mock epic is completely opposite. It's based on non-serious mood and it's very much light. And it is simply a mocking that simply aims to provoke a satirical humor. So that's all about epic. Thank you.